mysterious galactic mystery. Today we're gonna welcome nobody else but the black puppy.
Those were the visuals of Showtime 837 with Less Is More, an absolute beautiful masterpiece of a project. And obviously, I needed to find out more about it. And that's why I'm joined by Showtime 837 in studio himself. How's it going?
Everything blessed, man. How you feeling?
I'm feeling proper.
Happy to be here. Thank you for having me, man.
Nah, I'm happy that you are actually here.
Always.
I mean, I came through already before the interview started. I was like, you have been quiet for an entire year.
Yeah.
No drop, nothing.
Well, you know, I was busy. At least I was busy doing something. I was busy recording my drill album. And at the time, I was also basically migrating from my contract with RTE Records.
Okay.
There was a whole lot of stipulations that I had to just drop so much work in order to come back and resurface and restart again.
Okay, Nana, we are absolutely happy that you are back. And obviously, I saw the visuals right now.
Yeah.
Less Is More. Let's talk a little bit about that. What inspired that one? Especially since that you've been quiet for for a long time.
All right. Well, Less Is More is inspired by myself and my stories.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Whoever was listening attentively will get to know that I'm speaking on the terms of a survivor, right?
Okay.
And I'm speaking on terms of wisdom and knowledge. And basically, in a whole casing, the whole album of the Chimera Tape, where Less Is More comes from, is an album filled with hopeful messages, filled with messages of survival, of struggle, and also just overcoming one's battles. That's why that song is entitled Less Is More. Because at most times we forget to see how blessed we are, right?
Yeah.
Sometimes you wake up, you don't have anything, but you're breathing, your legs work, your hands work, your eyes can see, right?
Yeah.
And we forget to count those little blessings.
Nah.
And then so that's why it comes in where I say less is more. The less you have, the more you see how much you have.
Okay. I see that. I see that. When you're explaining it, I'm like, okay, actually true.
Yeah.
But even when I was listening to the music right now, Nick, I also said it gives a little bit of that Tupac situation. situation as well.
Yeah, I don't
know, maybe were you inspired a little bit by that?
Well, I was inspired by a whole lot of people, but musically, I was inspired by people like Dog, Gaza, Rashiyama. I was inspired by Jackson Kaoha. But there is a medium within me, right?
Yeah.
That advocates for true revolution in music.
Yeah.
So sometimes I will channel my inner Pac, sometimes I'll channel my inner Biggie, just to get that certain message across and in a way that you won't only hear it, but you'll feel it, right?
Yeah.
So that's where that energy comes from. You get me?
Absolutely. That, I love that energy. But you, in terms of producing the song, you produced it, WaveKit produced it, and then SMG Studio Africa's also came through with the mastering of it.
How did
that all come together, and how did that also just improve the quality of the song?
So SMG Africa is my baby.
Yeah.
It is my official record label and a talent management agency as well.
Okay.
And when creating SMG, I wanted to create a hub for artists to just come through and focus on the quality and the essence of music, right? We don't have to be releasing so much in order to bring out quality music. Okay. Sometimes discipline is better than consistency, because discipline makes sure that you are still staying on point, right?
Okay.
So WaveKit, he's from South Africa, he produced it. I myself did the recording, mixing and mastering.
Yeah.
So I'm the head of SMG. So when it comes to mixing and mastering, all those things go through myself.
No, absolutely love it. Of course, you had DD behind the camera.
Always.
One of the biggest names when it comes to, you know, videographer. So how did that come to play? You know, was he also directing, or did you kind of have like an idea of how you wanted the video to be already?
Well, I'm going to pull out the nepotism card.
DD
is my big brother.
I see it.
Yeah, you see it? DD is my big brother. So from the jump of my career, 90% of my visuals have been shot by DD Reloaded. And I think it's in a sense of like it's unspoken, you know. I'd send him a song and I'd say, yo, this is what I'm trying to do next, and he knows immediately what to do.
Okay.
Right, because we almost have that like twin telepathy, right?
Okay.
They say we look like twins, so I guess we have that.
Trust me, I see it.
You see? So he came through with the vision and he said, yo, you're not saying much in the song, but you're saying so much. And I told him I wanted images of, you know, just war, battles and everything, and he said just simply make it you and make it all about yourself, and the message will get across if it's said with the right intention. So DD made sure to bring us that beautiful visual, and yeah, shout out DD Reloaded.
I'm happy that he didn't go with your idea. Not that your idea was not cool, man, but I feel like this one, he knew what he was cooking.
That's why I leave it to him. I leave it to him. I trust him like that.
Obviously, you did give us like a snippet that you are talking about releasing an album. So before I let you go, can we talk about the plans that you have for the year that is 2024?
The plans for 2024 is to basically, number one, bring collaboration back to our industry.
Okay.
Right? We're now coming to a point where the industry has restarted and it has had the great reset. So many great artists have come out the seams, but we haven't yet established the art of collaboration, which is what our forefathers used to stand on. That was the foundation of our industry. So for this year, with that album, I'm trying to reestablish collaborating more and bringing together all of us, so that we can basically create this new unit, this new, it doesn't have to only be hip-hop, right? But it just has to be our industry, and we have to know that we're all together, we're all colleagues in one. So apart from the album coming out, I'm going to be doing a lot of collaborative works. On the album, I have the likes of Fatboy Luther, I have Script, I have Bobby Fanikasi, and so many other more people. And it's a drill album, and it's definitely, it's going to blow them by storm.
Okay, I'm excited, but obviously there are fans that are watching from home right now. They're like, oh my God, Showtime, it's been a while. You know, give them a little bit of, hey, how you doing, final words type of situation.
All right, what's happening? This is your boy Showtime 837, the sound of the sun, the sun of the sun. Thank you guys for having me. I've been gone for a while, but I was doing something great, and I'm glad to be back. I want to send a special shout out to SMG Studios, Dine Mob, to MXM Support Group for dripping me up today. They're my personal stylist.
Okay.
And to Dine Mob Studios. You know, we do this, and we do this for Namibia. We do this for 264. We do this for Southside. We on the rise. Blessed up. You're watching What the Guan.